everyone. Here I am with another product update. Recover and Build just got pumped up. Take a look at the difference. Right here, and I mean pumped up, at my cost. All right, we added 60 more tablets, so you can receive 2,000 milligrams more leucine, which is 5,600 milligrams, and over 3 times more isoleucine and valine, so that's 1,900 milligrams each in a single serving. And this is all based on the latest branched-chain amino acid supplementation science for specific goals beyond recovery. And I'll get to that in just a minute. We kept it the same price, so guess who's taking a hit? Me. And make sure you check out the new Recover and Build section in your Practitioner Dietary Supplement Reference Guide, or the PDSRG, to get way more info on branched chain than you need to know. And you know I do all that work for all you science heads out there. But more importantly, doing the work, which takes months of research, is what makes the formula. In other words, the formula comes from the work of scouring all the latest research, which is why we're always updating. And although we all know there are very few supplements that truly make a difference, the science on the ones that do moves very quickly. And not just in formulation, but proper dosing also. Now, before we get ahead of ourselves here, keep in mind, if you're taking Amino Boost for recovery and to maximize muscle protein synthesis, there's no reason to use Recover and Build, since Amino Boost also has the branched chains and the other amino acids shown to take muscle protein synthesis to the next level. In other words, beyond branched chain alone. Therefore, this new Recover and Build is meant for adults with this reasoning. Number one, adults that are attached to only using branched chain amino acids, and you'd be surprised how many there are out there that are attached to just using branched chain. Two, Amino Boost is not economically feasible or tolerable. Believe it or not, there are some people that have trouble with powders. Three, people that prefer a pill recovery formula for convenience. Or number four would be a clinical reason that requires only the branched chain amino acids. And there are some clinical reasons that require strictly branched chain amino acid dosing. And we do sell to doctor's offices, and therefore they order the product that way. But number five is the primary reason for the formula change: to potentially delay fatigue in endurance activities by occupying tryptophan transporters in the blood-brain barrier, thus inhibiting their ability to cross the blood-brain barrier, thus potentially reducing the production of serotonin, which we all know reduces energy. So this new formula and dosage recommendation is matched to this goal, while more than covering the amounts of branched chain shown to be effective in enhancing recovery. So here's the side note to this rationale beyond recovery. Branched chain amino acid supplementation during strenuous endurance type activities may help reduce fatigue and improve multiple choice reaction times, which is abbreviated MCRT, through its ability to contribute as an energy source during prolonged training and its potential to block serotonin production, as we just explained, by occupying the tryptophan transporters. And additionally, in this amount of branched chain amino acids, which is significantly higher, it may also reduce lactate levels, which of course is that burning effect. So for this goal, the research shows that branched chain amino acid supplementation supplied at approximately 45 milligrams per pound for the day of training, with at least 50% being leucine and up to 75% of the total milligrams, and the remainder split between isoleucine and valine, probably offers the greatest potential to deliver on this particular goal. So there you have it. So let's talk typical use. Number one, adult athletes and exercisers of any fitness level during intense or excessive training bouts to decrease muscle breakdown and enhance recovery and not using Amino Boost. Two, anyone attempting body fat reduction while maintaining or increasing lean body mass, not using Amino Boost. Three, for the new goal we just discussed. It could be for any intermittent athlete, so that's most of your team sports that last over an hour, that combine intermittent aerobic and anaerobic activities, such as obviously football, soccer, basketball, baseball, rugby, and any strenuous endurance athletes for reducing fatigue factors, as we discussed, such as rates of perceived exertion and mental fatigue. All right, minimum dose. Now here's where it gets a little bit different. Minimum dose, take 8 tabs 20 to 30 minutes before workout. If you're over 175 pounds, take 8 tabs 20 to 30 minutes before workout and add 2 to 4 tabs during your activity, somewhere around the midpoint. All right, final reminder. As mentioned, and all covered in your Recover and Build goal section of your PDSRG, the .fit Essential Amino Acid Formula, Amino Boost XXL, contain the branch chain in appropriate doses and may be of greater overall value for muscle protein synthesis than branch chain alone. Therefore, any additional supplementation with branch chain is most likely not necessary unless, as we discussed, there's a desire for continuous daily isolated branch chain dosing to maintain high plasma or muscle levels of branch chain in support of the supplement's putative anti-fatigue benefits during strenuous endurance activities. So there you have it. Your new Recover and Build, a pill alternative to Amino Boost and specific to a potential anti-fatigue goal. See you in the field.